And we are live at 6 tonight with a look the day after severe storms knock out power to thousands, snapping branches and trees and causing some serious damage. Good evening and thanks for joining us tonight. I'm Tracy Sable. The powerful line of storms rolled through parts of Maine late Sunday afternoon. Central Maine Power says at one point, 31,000 people were left in the dark. And tonight, significant progress is being made. The most outages remain in the western mountains and the foothills, with Oxford County still at more than 1,400. Piscataquis and Somerset counties also hard hit. In all, more than 2,800 people are without power tonight. And there is some remarkable storm damage today in the lakeside community of Oquossoc, just west of Rangeley. Officials suspect a microburst split hundreds of trees right in half yesterday afternoon. WMTW News 8's Paul Merrill joins us now live with the latest on this. Paul.
Tracy, check out the way the ground is torn apart here. That's because the wind during last night's storm was so powerful, it ripped this giant tree up by its roots, sent it crashing into the roof of this building.
And all of a sudden, it just came in big bursts, two or three, and it just came right through, crack, 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 crack.
The violent storm only lasted about an hour, but some people in the Oquossoc section of Rangeley will be cleaning up felled trees well into the summer. This huge tree smashed Bob Weatherby's shed. It missed his home by 3 feet.
If that tree was had gone on that cabin, it would have just collapsed those logs.
Bob and others watched the storm clouds roll in across Moose-Look McGuntick Lake.
It got really dark, so dark that the streetlights came on.
Chief Tim Pellerin and other emergency officials don't think a tornado hit yesterday, just a microburst, a straight line wind off the water.
There's lots of times it'll channel through the mountains and come across the lakes with an extreme amount of force.
It was more than just wind damage. Lightning struck this home in Rangeley. Back in Oquossoc, the property damage is more widespread.
Pulled that tree up and put it on top of our Jeep. So it was a little bit of excitement.
Folks around here say it was a good thing this storm did not come on a busier holiday weekend like the 4th of July, because they say if that had happened, there would have been a lot more tourists here and a lot greater chance that somebody would have been hurt. Live in Rangeley tonight, Paul Merrill, WMTW News 8.